Last time we talked about the attitude and with one life. Now, this is important fact, matter fact, because normally. We make the limitation, quality of oneself. I don't know what I'm saying. What I'm saying, we have attitude. Toward outset, the limitation quality. limited in quality. Now. One thing is rise yourself that you have such character, such quality, you know, which you never felt, never known, consciously or unconsciously, or you never felt, but somehow there are such quality, profound quality. It's contained within oneself. It's like, you know, our consciousness is like, you know, the ocean. Yeah. Which is the quality contained within that, you know, so many different animals, you know, different animals, yes, in the ocean, right? Oh, similar. In our experience of our consciousness or our mind, it's like ocean, you know, having so many, you know, imprint and the experience of countless good means, countless bad things. You know, existent right now within our consciousness. So that's reason I say we cannot make a limitation judge. I'm this, I'm that, you know? Wrong. Buddhist attitude, you're wrong. You know? Attitude thinking that I'm chicken, you know? I'm chicken, only I'm chicken. Or I'm pig. Pink. You understand what I mean, you know? You know? If you want to make clear, you know? You understand what I mean, you know? So these, you know, mentality, you know, those kind of mentality, I'm this, I'm that, is when you just point out one thing, but you can't see universal quality content within you. I really feel, Buddhist point of view, one sentient being, one human being has, you know, some kind of universal reality content within, you know, that, you know, as my faith, I don't know. Not sure. Do you feel certain your experience come up, which do you dream, which is beyond your concept? Do you have that kind of experience, you know, in your life? Certain skill, in other words, certain intelligence come out, thought come out, skill come out, you know, which you never dream, which you never thought about. You have that kind of skill, but somehow suddenly come out. You have or you don't. You do, okay.
Ha, 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 ha
Excuse me. You do that. You should aware. Which your own experience, you cannot ignore. That's why human being something really, you know, oh, so profound. Almost that your reality is, you know, beyond your imagination. Somehow, I don't know, human being is so, you know, so profound, so universal. So what then what is happening? If we have universal reality, you know, we are fantastic containers, then why do we recognize? Because the ego, the ego mind, is a sort of narrow mind. Giving our limitation, concept, or projection for oneself and the other. And this is the way we block. We crisp, you know, we suffocate. You know, that's the way we have been suffering, you know, conflict, you know, miserable stuff. If you break this, you know, suffocated channel of ego, mind, what is left over is the universal reality. Internal heart. That's why, limitation, judgment on oneself is the, you know, obstacle, in order to see, the profound, the universal reality oneself. This, you know, profound oneself is not something religious idea, not the philosophical, you know, idea. We talk about scientific reality. Living, you know, the quality as it is, without artificial, sort of flavor or projecting, such way. This the I talk about. We can investigate. That is the value of human being. That's why I say human being is something so, you know, profound, so positive. It is capable also, you know, not hopeless. It is capable to deal any kind of situation. Internal problem, external problem. We can deal. That is the, you know, beauty of human being. There is no problem which cannot be solved by human being. If we want it, now, when you understand your own truth of your own reality, then that begins satisfaction. You gain satisfaction. So the satisfaction, the quality is already existent. Matter have to discover. It's there. Matter you have to use skill and discover. It's like gold mine is there, existent. Matter is we have to discover, isn't it? It is the same thing. The satisfaction. The mind is there. When you understand truth. For example, when the princess, Shakyamuni, when he was, you know, his kingdom, what makes he change his life? Because he discovered some truth. Then he said, you know, remember, he changed his life because he wanted to become happy, you know. You understand? Not like that. Something he discovered. He thought everything pleasure is nice before. You know, somehow time passed. He looked at, you know, from his kingdom. You know, he looked at. He discovered some truth of suffering. Remember, you know his story of. He discovered truth of suffering, not he projecting. No. Not he make religious suffering. He just opened his eye. He look at it like this. He discovered the truth is come. You know, you understand? True existence of human being, miserable is, you know, he discovered. So that's why. This understanding made him, you know, to change his life. You understand? So, what I say, many Westerners like to change life. You know? They like to change. I'm not happy in my life. I like to change. Why do you change? Somewhere, you know. Changing is comes from something you discover, truth. You know? Well, of course, The true way changes, isn't it? You know, a good way changes if you discover truth. Bad way changes if you are clean to fantasy. You know, all this fantastic fantasy. Oh, you know, hallucinated. So you change your life. You know, going into hallucinated, you know, path and end up with a miserable, isn't it? Huh? Instead of find true happiness, you know, unhappy, a result come out. Oh. You see, people think that I don't know what I'm talking about. I don't know what I talk about. Anyway. Maybe this way to say. People think that changing is something. You believe, you know what I mean, you know, the idea of philosophical or religious idea, you know, you got change, you have to change, you do, I'm doing, something like that. I don't think so like that. The correct changing, you know, I'm talking about correct changing, you know. Correct changing is something gaining wisdom, understand some kind of true nature, some kind of reality that makes you change, that lead you then, quality of, you know, all this life. Mm. In other words, people keeping, you know, are the moral and the ethics, you know, following their lifetime. And these are the, not just, you know, idea to be good. They found some kind of truth, the evidence, through the experience. Right things to do, wrong things to avoid. So that way, we can change our motivation, our behavior, by understanding the truth of, you know, our situation. And the truth of your own experience. Concerning happiness life, let's say happiness life. I want happiness life, you know. I don't want a miserable life. So Buddhist attitude, happy life is existed within you right now. Sometimes you are miserable artificially. You are confused, but same kind, clean, clear quality of thought existent within oneself. So, if your mind is concentrated to bring the, you know, or the clarity, you know, of your own, you know, nature, you bring up, it's there, always there. It's up to you. That's why human being is so profound. It's capable, do things, capable. So for that reason, we should not satisfy with the such small worldly pleasure. We should understand the characteristic of worldly pleasure is, you know, is going, coming, it has limitation quality, impermanent, transitory. We have to understand. So there's no heavy burden, you know, or concept, you know, that I want you permanent, my friend. You know. It's not possible, isn't it? All of you, you know, becomes my permanent friend. If I ask you, please all of you be my, you know, permanent friend. We never separate from you. Please. Am I telling you reasonable or unreasonable? It's unreasonable, isn't it? How can I be, you know, the always, you know, existing with you? Not possible. Just fantasy. No. So we have to understand my relativity existent, your relative existent, it is the changing, transitory nature. I should not expect it, you know, beyond the, you know, the beyond the, you know, existence. So we have to understand not only human being, every relationship, you know, the sun, moon, earth, you know, you know, wealth, every relationship energy in this earth is so impermanent. It's not something philosophical matter. It's scientific evidence. So be ethical, okay? If you understand the truth of impermanent oneself and existence or outside, you know, make you easy going. Do not think up, you know, with the forcefully and be driving to be forced to be crazy. It comes from not knowing or impermanent truth. We are not leaving prison. You know, Buddhism, you heard. Leave prison aware. Instead of thinking fusion. You heard something like that. It's true. Okay. So we are not leaving prison world. We are leaving fantasy world projecting, you know, 10, 20 years, which is may not reality. So those things are extreme, you know, unrealistic. Buddhism we call permanent concept. Permanent concept, wrong concept. The reason why scared, you know, your friend disappear. You know, you worry, your friend disappear. You don't understand, actually, impermanent nature. Your friend is, you're speaking, your friend is permanent, your friend. So this way, you're scared. If you know your friend is impermanent, your relationship is impermanent, okay, changing. Changing is nature. Disappear is nature. We accept it as it is. For then, you have no fear. So those fear is comes from permanent concept, you know, which is basic, produced by the ego mind. You know? The ego mind is want security. No, I want you, when I use security, it's not something wealthy security. Security is something, you know, level, I in this. You want such way to put yourself, you know, build up such way. This is the security. Inner world security, set security. So the set security is permanent, you know, set, you know, projected. So in this way, permanent, you know, projecting everything. When you projecting oneself as permanent, self, then everything surround, world, your world is automatically sort of projecting such way, permanent, and have, you know, expectation. Well, you be careful. Maybe you think, I don't have you. You're a monk, you are wrong. You know? You know, we Westerners, we don't think that way. You know? We are impermanent. I'm going to say, yes, you do have here. This way, maybe you think permanent. But in your heart, you know, concerning reality, you think it's permanent. I'm going to answer this way. Yeah? Intellectually, you say, yes, impermanent. You know, sometimes I'm going to die. That is just intellectually. You talk about intellectual, philosophical, you know. But inside you, why you are afraid of dying, why you are afraid of disappearing your friend, you know, because you're not accepting, you know, because you're not accepting the truth of, you know, the changing. You know, even though you just have here, you know, concept, oh yes, it's changing, yes. You know what I mean, you know. Oh, you do make philosophical concept, but not true except. I'm not sure what I'm saying. Either. No, what I'm saying is, you be careful. Oh, when I say, you know, we have such a concept, permanent concept, you know, be careful. This permanent concept is not something obviously understood, you know. Oh, you understand? You cannot understand like suddenly. This concept which you have to investigate, how you feel yourself and the world. You understand? So the Buddhist point of view, that whole thing, what your ego projecting, permanent self, and this is the beginning, wrong start, wrong thinking. So you start, entire your relation is sort of permanent. You know? The deeper city inside your heart, that is the start. That concept you start. You know? And this way, we get fearful. Okay? Fear, you know? The symptom of fear, losing something. You know? Not only losing some relationship phenomena, and fear for death also. Because you're not accepting. Fear dead. Fear of death is okay, just that's good enough, you know. Fear of death is maybe intellectually you say, you know, existence and the die is natural. But the reason why you fear, you don't accept, okay? Or because the sick, you know, inside the sick mind, you know, don't want to accept, you know, the truth of death. So that you get fear. The whole thing. The fear, you know, holding fear is to come from not discovering truth of your life and death. If you understand, there will be no fear for you know, death, you know, death existence. You hear or you heard, there's no death, there's no fear. It's so natural, so natural. So that reason, Buddhism has good attitude for death. Buddhism has good attitude to the old. You know. To be old people is something natural. So it is a respectable object. You know, death and you know, old is old age is a respectable object. Buddhist point of view is nothing awful, you know. West point of view, awful, isn't it? Isn't it? To be old is awful. To be dead is awful. Buddhism, we understood karmic causation that, you know, to be old means to build up for the younger generation. So the younger generation also have responsible, which the giving by old people have to some degree return, you know, to old people. Somehow responsible. We should have that kind of attitude. Rather than thinking all people are useless, you know. They build up, so we have life. However, now, the point is, you know, the Buddhist attitude, you know, both life and death can be blissful, you know, a satisfied experience. For that reason, one should not have fear to be life, should not have, you know, fear, you know, to be, you know, to become, you know, death. It's something natural thing. Especially, it is a nuclear of life and death of human being is the, you know, the consciousness of the mind, not the will, not the, you know, this body. The way you call nuclear of human being is the consciousness. Everything we experience during the life, during the death, is everything is a conscious experience. So that this conscious, if we train in such way, mindfulness, you know, totally, you know, sort of awareness, the situation coming clear, then every situation is controlled without confusing. So that we have meditation. The death experience, the meditation, we bring right now. We train in such way. And then the time comes. No problem. No problem. We have to make a preparation. You know? We have to learn how to, you know, good way to die. It's so simple, you know. The actual death comes, you know, everything situation control can be so, you know, much more maybe blissful happening than lifetime. It's possible. I'm sure you heard Buddhist books, you know, and many information that sounds like one should be scared for death. You know, embassy, you should be have scared, afraid for death. Therefore you practice the Dharma. Something like you heard this way? You heard this way. Actually, metaphor the other way. Now, this have to be understand Western mind. It means before the dead, actual dead come. We are training our mind. That is the main point. You should practice in. You should meditate, because you're scared for death. Sounds like, isn't it, sometimes translated in such a way, isn't it? No, I don't know. You heard that way? Actually, you know, Western mind, they can't fit here. But so logical. You have to go this tunnel, you know, isn't it? You know? This tunnel, you know, which is yourself alone. You know? There's no your friend taking with you, you know? So, you have to make preparation. Isn't it? Before you go that tunnel. That's logical. So you cannot be lazy, you know. Sometimes you have to make preparation, I don't know. If you know when you're going to die, then if you be lazy, you know, you can delay it for next year. Since you don't know, you know, your death is next life, next year, or, you know, 2 years later, or maybe next hour, or who knows, you know. So the better, hurry up, you know. Anyway, okay, you know, my reason, it sounds like hurry up means, you know, something dramatic, you know, I hurry up. No, not like, relax more. More relaxed, you can do better. Don't you think, you know? You know, when you hurry so much, you know, you seem you're doing, but you do nothing, isn't it? So therefore, be careful. All right. So, it's very important, you know. All of us, we want to be happy. With the prayer, how can you be happy? Communicate or no? Huh? Human beings should be happy, okay, Buddhist point of view. We should be satisfied, we should be happy, we should be tranquility peaceful. With the full of prayer, How can we be happy? How could be we happy? Oh, isn't it? Okay. You think about all kind of fear. You think about all kind of fear. Any kind of fear you think of should be completely eliminated. Okay, you do have skill to eliminate. Oh, then the true rest comes. Otherwise, you can't rest, isn't it? You go holiday, you go on the beach, lie down your like this, you know, you lie down your body, you know, sun burning, but the mind is like this, you know, boiled, you know. How could be you rest, isn't it? So the rest is, true rest is mind rest. Not only, you know, not have fear during the death is something valuable. You know, death experience is something really valuable experience, Buddhist point of view. Something precious thing also, not only, you know, not fear, something energy you can utilize, you know, or like gold mine, you know, you can utilize. You know, that's precious experience. To produce more happiness. It becomes, you know, it's, in other words, that the experience and the process, it becomes, you know, sort of part to liberation. You know, part to egolessness. Yeah? Sort of fear. And build up ego, it becomes, you know, the part of all to reach, you know, beyond the ego, right? Beyond the fear, beyond the miserable. So this is the, you know, point. I think John Landa, he told me, he did, you know, the meditation, you know, the process. I think all new students, I'm sure, understood such a way. That's why, the not only, you know, that experience, you know, could be good thing, but can be used such energy, enlightened experience. In other words, you know, enlightened experience you can use. When we say Buddhism, that experience, you know, that experience and also going into the state, is we're not saying our body is going from the dead to the, you know, intermediate state, you know, but conscious experience. Conscious experience. Oh. Understand, you know, conscious experience. I mean, Western world, many non-believer, religious believer people, has experienced the body is like, you know, dead, you know, but mind is experiencing such trip. Now, the reading many books like that. So I want you to understand, the experience of consciousness is something Buddhist make up, you know, philosophical. It is more rather scientific, you know, than philosophical or religious idea. For example, even our life, since we were born up to now, how many things you experience? You think you are always human being, you know? Your behavior was always human being. I'm human being, you know? I'm always human being. I'm going to say no. Sometimes your behavior is chicken behavior, you know? Sometimes you thinking chicken thinking, chicken behavior. Sometimes you pig thinking, pig behavior. Sometimes you cow thinking, cow behavior. Sometimes you are human being, human attitude, human behavior. I think so. Well, you know, so you see, Buddhism, we not consider this body shape, you know. You know, this body shape, you know, this body shape. I always emphasize the nucleus of human being is the conscious thing. Conscious thing, not the body here. So the mind is experiencing dull-aged attitude, you know, dull experience, you know, intelligent attitude. You know, so different the experience. So the one life, metaphysics, you experience so many different, you know, style. We talk about it, you heard Buddhism, six realms, isn't it? You heard the six realms, something like that, you know? Yeah. Well, physically, yes, we look like human beings. But somehow, sometimes we are hungry ghosts, you know? Isn't it hungry ghosts or no? If the inner mentality is enough, Buddhist point of view, you don't need to emanate yourself, you know, such, you know, you understand? It's enough psychological driving force. You emanate yourself. That is good enough. Not the physically, your stomach is bigger like that, and this one skinny, something written here sometimes, you know? It's not necessarily. Psychological experience, driving is good enough. So, you know, I want you not necessarily you believe, you know. You understand? You become, you know, Buddhism after the life, you repent, and then, possibility you become, you know, donkey or monkey or something like that, you know. And not necessarily, man, not necessarily. But you should understand the donkey, monkey, you know, pig and the chicken mind, you know, you understand it somehow. Relatively, we have communication, isn't it? You know, if the mind becomes like that, it's possible, isn't it? That is good enough, you know, to go in progress or to going down. I know Western mind, difficult, you know. There's a, I'm intelligent now, you know. How can I become pig in the next life? You understand? But within attitude and the philosophical, you know, observation, we're not sort of, you know, surprised at the idea. Because some of the, you know, human beings, you can see our life, you know. They are intelligent, you know what I mean, you know, they dignity, they think somehow, you know, they slipped, they changed their, you know, such a way. They become like vegetable, isn't it? Do we saw some human being are like vegetable? Huh? Yes, so. Excuse me, maybe they have taste, no same as, you know. But mind is vegetable, isn't it? Vegetable mind, yes? You know, how you accept that one? How do you explain, you know? For me, difficult too, you know. I have many students. Some, you know, they are so unbelievable, you know, intelligent and idealistic. Suddenly they become completely dull. I have many students, Western, you know, students like that, you know. For me also, I'm surprised. Huh? But I understand, you know. I understand why. Such intelligent, you know, girl or man, suddenly becomes, you know, crazy, you know, and, you know, suffocated, and cannot do anything. Huh? You know, of course, we're surprised, we don't understand this one. You know, we're so pity, you know, why this intelligent man, intelligent girl, suddenly, you know, hopeless, you know? Huh? And almost become vegetable, you know? Why? Difficult to accept, isn't it, ideally? But reality, that is, isn't it? Oh. So, I'm not saying our body becomes vegetable, you know, flower, you know. Body is there, but inside, the quality, isn't it? The, you know, the, you know, to comprehend and to discriminate what is right, wrong, relatively, lose sense, you know. So that way, so that's where I want you to understand that a human being is, we are, maybe now we are normal, you know, we are normal now. We are normal, but we have quality, you know, tomorrow to become vegetable, you know. Okay, so be careful. Be careful. Be careful. That not surprise, but not come like this, you know. That you build up energy. Buddhist point of view, not just come accidentally. Buddhism, you know, understand evolution again. You know, you from the, you know, intelligent to becoming vegetable, it has also evolution. You know, history. You know, to come out that situation. So that we have actually our choice to change that situation. You understand? We do have the, you know, skill. So you don't worry that the Buddhism, you know, has idea that after the die you be, you know, human being become chicken and, you know, pig, you know. All this are for me difficult to accept. I don't worry you, that one. But I want you understand intelligent human being degenerated, becomes pig attitude, chicken mentality, and it becomes vegetable mentality. Oh, that's good enough. That's good enough. Okay. That is good enough. Not very idea. I think one should give question like this, or thinking this way, that you said that there is, you know, the future life, you know, after the death. Do you have, you know, do you have experience? You know, how can you monk say, you know, Tibetan monk, you monk, how can you say there is a life after the death? You know, or you experience? I hope you know, because you are this life now, isn't it? So, one shouldn't give that kind of question. Then maybe I ask you, you know, you should not believe also death. You should not accept death, because you not experience death now. Do you have that experience now? You're not dead, isn't it? I hope you're not dead. I don't know, my logic is maybe it doesn't work, you know. It doesn't work. Come on. No, Westerners, they told me sometimes ago, how could you say next life existent? How you know next life? You telepathically know? They asked me like that. I cannot say I have telepathic power. You know? That's the reason I'm telling after the life existent, you know? Because I have telepathic power. Okay, you don't have telepathic power. So how can you say? Or you have experience? You don't, isn't it? So you don't have telepathic power, you have no experience. How can you say? Western mind are asking me all the time like that. certain thing, ignore something sensory, you know, you experience. Ignore sense object, you know, but experience of consciousness. So you have to understand. Also, the characteristic of consciousness is not something, you know, physical, the form and the color. It's just, you know, energy, the clarity energy, taking reflection of all existing phenomena. That is the consciousness. So the consciousness, the characteristic of consciousness is clarity. So whenever you look at your thought process, remember when we meditate, we just, you know, doesn't matter what state of your mind, even negative state of mind or positive state, whatever it is, just look at that situation. That we experience the subject of the thought, its nature is clear. So the without, you know, or artificial, you know, the level, you know, good, bad, you just, you know, leave and let go. And also, the death process, the vision, these things, you can experience before the death. Before the death. And we are sleeping, you know. Sleepy time also has the element, you know, the vision changes. Different colors. These are exactly this is similar. We do have the experience, matter. We have to, you know, aware, you know. We have to aware.